What's up, man?
Man, what is the word?
Oh, man, God is the word.
What you got going down there in Florida? We live, so they'll start pouring in here. What you got going down there in Florida?
I guess, to make a long story short, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Okay.
You know, that's pretty much what we got going on right now. And that's I'm hopeful that's what's going to be going on for the, you know, for the duration of my lifetime.
I didn't title this live. Life is about progression. I know we were talking a little bit before this, and you were saying that you just got done playing a round of golf.
I did, over at Suntory Country Club in Melbourne, Florida.
So can you tell me a little bit about, hey, you know, the cigar you smoking, and I see you got the polo one. Man, we're gonna start with the.
Yeah, absolutely. So this cigar here is my own line of cigars, the A. Baruti Collection. I am Akili Baruti, and this is my cigar company, Fairway Cigar Company. This shirt that you're seeing me wear is my cigar lounge that I own, Fairway Cigar Lounge, which we will be opening within the next couple of weeks in the Avenues of Vieira in Melbourne, Florida.
I must ask, just because, again, I don't know if I wanted to start. I heard this story one time, or it was a comedy sketch where they were saying about, man, Michael Jackson, you know, he was owning, you know, he owned the Tigers and the Lions and stuff like that. And the comedian was saying, man, you know, we wouldn't know who do you call if you wanted to get, you know, a lion. You would be calling your local zoo trying to buy their lion. Like, no, that's not how that works.
That's not how that works.
Right. So I guess for one who, I wouldn't know where to start if I'm, you know, trying to open a cigar lounge. I was just at Churchill's yesterday. So how do you, where do you start if you're trying to, like, open up a cigar lounge? Like, who is the phone call you make? Is it to an investor? Is it to the city? Like, how does that start?
No, all of that's important, but the start of it comes from a fond knowledge and appreciation for what it is that you're getting involved with.
Okay.
So for me, it started back in Virginia, Minnesota, back in 2002, when I was the roommate to a Cuban American, to a Cuban American whose father was a Cuban immigrant that hand rolled cigars.
Wow.
So he would send his son cigars, and, you know, his son would keep them in his room and he would smoke them. He would, you know, enjoy them and take a deep breath. Mind you, I come from, you know, Muskegon Heights, Michigan. We don't know nothing about no cigars. What we know about cigars is Swish the Sweets,
right,
Phillies, Optimo, Backwoods. And so we're in the dorms one night, and my roommate was out on a date, and it was late. And of course, we were looking for some papers to roll. We didn't have anything, and okay. I remember that he kept a box of cigars in his room. Not knowing anything about cigars, I'm thinking they just cigars. Look, if he got a problem, I can buy him another box tomorrow, and everything will be good.
Right.
So that I went there, got a couple cigars, two of his Cuban cigars that his father's rolled, bust them things down. You know, rolled them up, smoked them, and didn't think much of it. And when he came back to the room that night, and was upset that, you know, we went and got some of his cigars, and he wasn't upset that we went and got some of the cigars. He was upset that we got the cigars dumped out the tobacco and used the leaf to roll up some blunts. And he's like, you don't even know what you just did, man. My dad put his blood, sweat, and tears to get me those cigars. And if you were going to smoke the cigar, I wouldn't have had a problem. But to do that with it, man, the cigar is worth more than what you're smoking. And he was my friend, my roommate. He didn't talk to me at that point for like 2 months. And there was nothing I could do to apologize to him.
Really?
There was no words. I mean, I apologized. I tried to apologize. He wasn't hearing it. He was devastated. He went 2 months without talking to me. So at that moment, what I ended up doing, because I valued his friendship, I went out and I decided that I'm going to educate myself on why these cigars are so important to him.
Okay.
Because I cared that much for him to at least educate myself on why they were so important to him.
Right.
And in educating myself, I grew a fond appreciation for cigars.
Okay.
And so this started back in 2002. So I've been going all over the world, literally trying different cigars, smoking different cigars. You know, it became a hobby of mine. It became a pastime. And, you know, how my mind operates, I'm the person that if I'm going to spend a lot of money on something, then I'm at some point in time, I'm going to realize, you know, that it's about time for me to get a return on the money that I spent.
Sure.
So in all those years of me educating myself on cigars and me, you know, meeting with people, talking with people, you know, just getting a fond appreciation for you know, business as well. I said, let me see if I can try my hand in this particular line of business. And so that's ultimately what I ended up doing. And, you know, here we are today in 2023. I have my own line of cigars. I have my own lounge that you can buy these cigars and you can enjoy your night sitting down at Fairway Cigar Lounge smoking a Baruti cigar with